This is a review of the 1863 hotel, room 383. I bet you didn't know this hotel had an annex that you could go to with lots of other rooms that are slightly bigger and more equipped than a lot of the other rooms that are here. So to start, we're gonna come over by the door and swing over to where our king size bed is. And there you can see one nightstand just hanging out there. And we'll just kind of pull this back, try and get you the full effect of the room here. So you can see the wood paneling on the back wall there, the king size bed. Got a little art up here, Civil War related. Horrible reflections, filming this at a very bad time of day. Coming down, nightstand with electrical socket right built in. That's nice. You've got your alarm clock here again with power plugs on top. Again, a nice little add right there. And we'll come back, show you the bed, and then swing back around to our other nightstand with the telephone on it, another with a plug in it. Now, these two side ones and every other light in here turns on manually. So it doesn't turn on with the light switch that's right by the door. So you'll have to actually turn these on yourself. There's a couch feature right here with a light behind it and some more artwork. You've got kind of a, I'm gonna call it a bench, but I'm using it to store stuff. And over here we have a chair, kind of high back chair with another light, more art. This particular room, since I have the window wide open, is on the third floor of the annex building, and here you can see kind of what you're looking at. This is the Jenny Wade gift store right there, and if I pop this up just a little bit, right there, those two chimneys are actually to the Jenny Wade house, and I have no idea what happened there. I will find out sometime during the week. We're gonna come around here. This particular room, once the light adjusts, has a microwave and mini fridge. So that's kind of nice. A lot of the other rooms don't have a microwave and a mini fridge. Refrigerator, open up, has a freezer, and then plenty of room over here for sodas and bottles of whatever. So nice space, good to have. You've got a, you know, flat screen TV dresser that you can put some stuff in. You have a air conditioning slash heating unit that does seem to be able to run constantly. I will test that out as I stay here. The other window for this particular room kind of looks out into the parking lot here. So you can kind of see you're right next to the main thoroughfare with this particular one. You've got your stand with ice bucket. You have your workstation. So again, plug, light, socket. That looks like it's an Ethernet plug right there. We'll find out. There is another telephone right there, as well as your coffee maker. And seating, there is another Ethernet jack right there. I will check and see if that works. And we're gonna kind of come back this way to the corner one more time, because this also has a ceiling fan that is independently controlled of everything else. So you can actually have the ceiling fan going without the heater or the AC going. And we're going to come back to the door really quick, because that is actually where the controls are located. So light switch that turns on the one light behind me, and then a switch for the fan. And we'll come across to the right to show you that you do have an iron slash ironing board. Up here you have extra linens, and this is kind of like your little cubby to hide all of your stuff. But one of the main reasons that you're going to get this is actually over here, which is the bathroom. So coming into the bathroom, we'll just open this door up right here. You've got a very nice double sink right there. To the right of the door, you have your standing shower. So we'll find out how well this is. You know, I did forget to show that in the shower itself, the hardware, since I'm so out of practice. Hardware looks nice. If we come up here, you can see your shower head variable. So you got a couple different settings that you can do here. The walls themselves are actually tiled walls. They are not rebathed, so that looks nice. And since this is after we actually started, right here, you'll notice that they have pumps for shampoo and stuff instead of bottles.
The ceiling, we have
heat lamp, which is controlled over here. We'll swing around, it's got nice tiling, your commode right there. There are two mirrors right there, and you can see the sink and its fixtures. Nice cabinetry down there. Your countertop and drawers, some of them are real and have soft clothes. Some of them are not real. Down here, this is the double one right here. I put the hairdryer, which is normally hanging up over there, but you do have soft clothes with the double sink. Even these over here, which open up so that you see under the sink and have access to extra teepee, are also soft clothes, which is important when you have something like that. But over here to the left, this is what you're getting it for. This is the only other type of room here, except for the specialty room. I'll have a review in the corner there that has the nice big jetted hot tub. So that is what you're getting this room for. And then you have, you know, towels pretty much everywhere. So it is a very nice looking room. We will be staying here for a week. We will find out how well the room is, because on the other side of this wall is the door to get up and down. And then if we come over here, this wall all the way at the end of the bed here is the door exit. So it might be kind of trafficked. We'll find out. There's only three other rooms on this floor except for this room, and this room takes up one side just because of the size and the very nice amenity that is the bathtub. So like I said, we'll be staying here for a week. We'll find out what works, what doesn't work, and let you know. All right, so this is wrap up after spending 5 days here. Few things to talk about, notable, starting with our bed here, king size bed, nice size. However, I'm gonna call this a little firmer than I would like in a bed. So keep that in mind. If you need a softer bed, that's kind of firm. You might not get a comfortable night's sleep on that. Speaking of the bed, while we're on the bedside, here is the bed, here is the door. And remember that this bed is sharing a headboard with the wall to the outside hallway. Over there is the door that people can take in and out of the building, and that corner there is the smoking section. See inserted picture here, where people can smoke and have it vape around this way and get to your air conditioner, or you can just hear people talking and being chatty over there. The other thing is on this side, right here, you have the stairwell, and then there's an air conditioner in the stairwell going down. You can hear that too overnight. The door itself is, you know, it's a door. You can see light underneath and through the side. And anytime somebody opens that door to get up here or this door to get up here, you're going to hear it if you don't have a white noise machine. Likewise, all the doors kind of slam, so you'll hear that too. So walls are kind of paper thin. One plus is that underneath us, there is only the workout center, but currently during filming is not open, so you don't have to worry about that. Coming over this way, you know, little couch thing, kind of nice. Footstool, also nice. You can see we've got our partial computer setup. Out this way, you've got the Jenny Wade. As we discussed before, you do hear traffic. Not terrible. If you were in the front of the building, you'd hear a lot more, but you do hear, and see, we have somebody walking right there. So there, and we're just gonna swing across really quick to the front here to show you out this way. You've got a parking lot with stuff right in front of you. So you will hear people in and out in the morning. The air conditioning slash heating unit right here, which is kind of coming into focus now. Air conditioner, you can have the fan on at all times and you'll be perfectly fine. However, if you're using heat, the heat will cycle the fan on and off. Over here, we've got the desk setup. Very useful, very nice. You can see right there, I have my mini Wi-Fi spot. That does not actually work, nor does the one on the desk lamp, as I thought. One thing that I noticed with this particular hotel is that the Wi-Fi can be kind of spotty. No problems for my wife's phone, only problems with my phone. Both our laptops connected perfectly fine. Don't know if I showed you this before, but you do have a nice large mirror right there, as well as in the bathroom, you have a set of double mirrors, which I will not be showing you. Over there in the corner, ironing board and iron. And spinning one more time, because I don't know if I actually mentioned this, there is a ceiling fan, which is rather nice to help move the air around if you are using the heater. Now, if we're coming into the bathroom, let's quickly go through here. We have our shower station. The shower head was adjustable. I did enjoy that. No problems with the hot water, good water pressure, good temperature. The commode was perfectly fine. They do give you a double set of toilet paper, which was nice. The double sink was also very useful. If you go hoteling and don't do a double sinks are always useful. The only problem is the sink is located in the bathroom with the shower and the hot tub. Now, speaking of the hot tub, this is definitely meant to be a single person, single use hot tub. You can get two people in here if you get creative. I'll leave it at that. The wainscoting, which I don't think I mentioned before, is kind of nice. It adds a little extra elegance to it. And then you got some paintings right there, which kind of help bring it together. Now, as far as my overall feelings of this particular room for the hotel, which is room 383 at the 1863 Inn, it is a nice hotel. It is a nice hotel room if you're looking for something that you need a little more space, that has a microwave and a mini fridge, and you want something in the annex, which is kind of nice because this gave me more of a hotel feeling than a motel feeling. The door situation is very similar to a motel, but you have to walk up into a building to get here. They say it's on the third floor, but it's actually on the second floor of the annex, but you can take the elevator in the main building to the third floor, and then there's a walkway. Keep that in mind. I didn't know that there was a way to do that, and I lugged stuff up three flights of stairs or two flights of stairs if you use the door in the back, which automatically locks on you. Just keep that in mind. Overall impressions, the room was good. There are some things I wish were better, but for the price and location, remember 1863 Inn is location, location, location. You can't do any better. It's a really decent room. If you have questions or comments, let me know down in the area below, and thanks for watching.